And I was also thinking to, you know, as a partnership manager in South Asia region, I was thinking to, you know, find like-minded organizations like Teach for India and something else, you know, who can be part of it and can help the community in executing these, you know, trainings in at local levels in different schools and universities. Only then will we talk, you know, we'll be able to share more about Wikipedia. We'll be able to share the enthusiasm of volunteerism and the motivation.
So Wikipedia and classrooms, we'll definitely see what we can do about it. No doubt. But Praveen, we were also requesting, to set up a wiki source for Goa, no, where we could put copyright expired books in a say subdomain or some folder there, all related to Goa, because we have quite a lot, Goa and Konkani and, you know, all these things. There is a World Konkani Conference which has scanned a lot of books in Mangalore. So if it's out of the copyright domain, if they are willing to share, why not, no? It's very doable, it's very low-hanging fruit, I feel.
Absolutely. And standard, you know? The idea is great. It's just that I don't know the technicality of it, and, you know, I'm not the right person to talk about wiki source, but I have, you know, as I said, you know, I'm talking to Sandeep about it. I'm not sure whether, you know, how the technicality works. Like, do we need to create a category or, you know, a specific section for Goa books? So I'll find it out and, you know, we'll keep talking about it. But I'm, you know, super interested, and I really see, you know, the opportunity of creating or getting so many books on Wikisource. I'm really up for it.
May I add something?
Yes.
Yeah, wiki source is there in many Indian languages. Marathi has one. So does Gujarati. It is there in Punjabi. It is there in Bengali. It is there. I think it's there in almost all the South Indian languages. I from WMF side, I think it is Sandeep who is the coordinator. But from CC2K side, it is Jayanta Datta, and Jayanta Datta is a hands-on man. Plus, I am quite sure that there are at least in Kannada community, there are people who are into, you know, very very much into, you know, into the technical side also of Wikisource. And Wikisource guys are, you know, they are very passionate about the stuff that they do. So I would say that it's not a question of breaking fresh ground here. There is more than enough expertise in India and guidance available. It's just a question of getting down to it and going through the procedure, and setting up a wiki source has no, there are no hidden barriers or challenges as such.
Just one word on wiki source, Hasan. Can you explain wiki source for those who might not?
Yeah. See, we've got all these Wikimedia projects which serve different purposes. The purpose of Wikipedia is to be an encyclopedia. The purpose of Wikimedia Commons is to be a repository for multimedia and all such things, from where it can both serve all the Wikipedias, 323 of them, and other thousand Wikimedia projects, as well as a place from where people all around the world can take Creative Commons licensed stuff. Wikisource is also another project, but its job is to be a repository of published material which is in the public domain. So that's very clear. Or where the license rights has been released by the particular author, so that you can have a Creative Commons right in it. And it's not just a question, Wikisource is not a scanning thing. It's that means that OCR, optical character recognition of the text, is done, and in that particular language, in that particular script, you have to have that thing either manually or through the use of computer means placed and typed out, and then you have to carry out all sorts of actions and curate the page, so that that book is there. And Wikisource is a very good way to read a particular any book that you want, because it gives you all sorts of hyperlinks to go between chapter and this and that and all. So it's very suitable. It's much better than, say, Gutenberg or even Internet Archive, because once you have text which is OCR'd, you can do all sorts of things with it. You can change the magnification, you can do such stuff with it. Whereas those other projects, what they're giving, they're just giving you either plain raw text unprocessed, in the case of Gutenberg, or in the case of Internet Archive, they are basically showing you what they've scanned. And in their case of the OCR, it's all machine OCR and it's faulty. So it contains errors, and they're just not going to be able to cope up to correct those errors, anything of that, in any time soon. As far as wiki sources concerned, all these the question of scanning and converting to optical character recognition and curating, that means checking word for word, grammar for grammar, everything that has been printed, every caption that is there, every image which is there, even all those cute little drawings in the end on the tops of the books and all that thing, as much of that is included into that, and it's all digital text. It can be used in any kind of device whatsoever. So it's a superior project in my opinion to the others. Others are better as interim holders of your stuff, but your final product, that means suppose you got a book and it's public domain and you scanned it, you can upload it and keep it in Commons, or you can upload it and keep it in Internet Archive, but it is best that you put it up in Wikisource. That is, finally your aim is to take it from there, do all the work and put it up in Wikisource, and then you can relax and say, oh yes, I've done something.